Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's review two of the most common fragmentation pathways seen in mass spectrometry, charge and radical site-initiated fragmentation. Most organic molecules that are analyzed have at least one atom with a lone pair, a nitrogen, oxygen, or halogen atom. So here is an alkyl chain, six carbons long, and we will add an atom with a lone pair. Let's assume we have an OH. During ionization, an electron will be removed from this molecule, and that electron will most likely come from a lone pair. With one electron removed from the lone pair, here is the structure of our parent ion, the radical cation of the original molecule with a charge, Z value, of plus 1. Its mass is 102. Note that the sample will generate millions and millions of parent ions, just like this one. Some of these parent ions may survive intact and be detected as the parent ion. Parent ions that do not fragment give a signal with an MZ value that corresponds to the nominal mass of the original molecule, 102 in this case, and can give information on the molecular mass of the original molecule. Let's now talk about fragmentation. Here we have two of the same parent ion from the previous slide. The first type of fragmentation is charge site initiated, and we're going to break the CO bond. This can happen in two ways. One way is the bond can break heterolytically. Both electrons going to the oxygen. That would form an OH fragment that is neutral and still a radical. OH would be the radical fragment. The rest of the structure, the cation fragment, which is what will be detected in the MS. Its mass is 85, so its MZ value is 85. The other fragmentation option would be for the CO bond to break homolytically. One electron can go to the oxygen and the other to the carbon. That would give a neutral carbon radical, which would not be detected. The OH fragment has a positive charge and would be the fragment cation with an MZ value of 17. Which of these will happen? It depends. Both could happen, or maybe one would be favored. It depends on the relative stabilities of the fragment radicals and fragment cations. So in the mass spectrum, you might observe one or both or neither of these cations. It just depends on their relative stabilities. Let's finish with radical site initiated cleavage. Here again is our same parent ion, two of them on the left. We're going to use the radical to break a bond that is remote from the radical site. One option is homolytic cleavage. The radical on oxygen swings down, forms a CO pi bond, and an attached carbon group is lost. So here is the outcome. We form two fragments. One is a fragment radical, the other is a fragment cation. And in this case, the fragment cation is what will be observed. It has an MZ value of 73. We can also consider a heterolytic cleavage. Let's draw that outcome. This oxygen is unchanged and will still be plus. This carbon now has a lone pair and will be negative. And here is a cation. So we will get two fragments. One fragment is a cation. The other fragment is net neutral and will just be considered a radical. The fragment that we will observe will be this one, the ethyl cation. It has an MZ value of 29. Again, the favored cation depends on the relative stabilities of the pairs of fragments. We have other bonds that could also undergo radical site-initiated cleavage, and breaking those other groups, those other bonds, would generate even more possible fragments. Almost every molecule has many different possible fragmentations, but usually one or two will dominate in the mass spectrum. That was a review of fragmentation through charge and radical site initiation, two of the most common fragmentation pathways. Please leave a like, make a comment, or consider subscribing to the channel. Take care.